chart here. So when we get to each person, we'll put the chart, you have a picture of it, but when we have a bigger chart here. So the first one is going to be a chart on repentance by Elizabeth. All right, we're ready.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Elizabeth, Sister Elizabeth. What's your name?
I'm Jim.
Pleased to meet you, Jim. Do you know anything about church life? Do you know anything about God?
I've heard a little bit, but not much.
Do you know anything about God?
He created the world.
Do you know how to pray to God?
Doctor?
Do you know how to pray to God for forgiveness?
I think so. I'm not sure.
You do know what repent is?
Not really, no.
When you sin, you ask God for forgiveness?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Do you believe God will give you forgiveness?
I think so. I've done some bad things, so I'm not sure.
Well, we'll tell you a little bit about forgiveness. Right, I'll tell you that. Have a wee seat.
Thank you.
Repent. Repent is when you do something wrong and you just more or less learning about God, right? And the first time you repent is when you ask God if you can forgive, right, for what you've done. Because when you repent to Jesus about your sins, you feel an uplift, right? You feel cleansed. You really do. And sometimes you really cry because you feel that overwhelmed with God and what He's doing in your life when you start repenting, right? And I will give you some. You pray every day for repentance, right? Because the more you repent, the more God fills in your system. In your spirit, you really feel God. The more you repent, you really do feel God. And you feel a cleansiness, and you feel you feel very, very good. You really do. But you need to start repenting before you actually feel that. And it will come to you, and it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. So do you know any knowledge of faith?
What do you mean, faith? Like just
about God, about what you've been praying for, and see when you do something wrong, you don't tell anyone else about what you've done wrong, right? It's only God, because it's only God that can forgive you, because it's God that made you, right? God made you. God gives when you repent your sins, God gives you grace. And grace is a beautiful thing. It really is a beautiful thing. You want to open your Bible and we'll go to Luke 13:3, and it tells you about repenting.
Okay.
You go to Luke 13.
Where would I find Luke?
Well, see if you go to the front of your book, your Bible. It tells you all right. The very beginning, there's a list there of what you've got. Right, and if you look down, usually it's got the start, and if you look for Luke, there you go there, Luke. You go to the page there,
okay.
Right, so you go to Luke.
Luke, okay.
Uh-huh. And see, once you read your Bible all the time, you'll find this even easier to find it. And you'll actually feel good at been doing that. You'll be like, oh, I found a page, and I need to read that page in here, and you feel it. Right, so when someone's saying to you, once you learn, it takes a while, everybody's different.
Yeah.
Right? But once you learn, and if I'm saying to you, go to Luke in 13, in paragraph 3, right? So you just go to your Luke, and it's got all the pages on it, right? It's got all the numbers on it as well. And there's your 13 and you go down to 3. Right? Sometimes you can circle it if you want. You can read it, and if you think it's good and When you read the Bible, sometimes you feel this. It's just that it's like a passion, that somebody's saying just things to you. And see if you feel that when you're reading your Bible and you feel this passion. Get a wee circle on it, and when you're kind of feeling down or something like that, you can go back to it. Mm-hmm. And you read it, and it gives you this good urge, good feeling. Because you do, you get a wonderful feeling. So would you like to read me 13, paragraph 3?
Okay. I tell you no, but unless you repent, you too will all perish. Mm-hmm.
So that's one of your first steps, right? When you hear God and you want to be with God, right? Mm-hmm. And you want to walk with God. That's one of your first. You've got three, right? And your first step to God is repent.
Okay.
Right? That's your first one. Because you need to repent for God. And what God knows, what you've done wrong, He likes you to tell Him. Because see when you're telling Him, you know then that you've really done wrong, and you're telling God, yes, I've done wrong because I've done such and such. So in yourself, you know you've done wrong. You're actually realizing now that you have done wrong. Although God knows all along what you've done, but you're telling Him that you know that you've done wrong and that you're sorry, and God forgives you. God forgives.
Okay.
More than us humans and us boys. We don't, it's very hard for us to forgive, but God really forgives, and that's why we're doing that. Okay, do you understand that? You want me to give you another example in it? On it, you want to go in Matthew 3, page 3 in Matthew. But I told you to go back here, right? And it gives you them all, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just look up Matthew. Eventually you'll learn to be quick with this. You'll just fill it up, woof.
Okay.
Right, and it'll give you the number that it's in.
Page, alright, thank you. 1,035.
Right, when you go to 1,035.
Okay, found it.
Right, and it is 3,
mm-hmm.
Verse 3.
Verse 3.
Okay. Matthew, verse 3, and it's 17. Okay. And would you like to read that?
Mm-hmm.
You got it?
Yeah. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my son whom I have loved. With him I am well pleased."
Sorry, yes.
3:12.
Have you got it? Matthew
chapter 3, verse 12.
Uh-huh.
Okay. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor, gathering the wheat into his barn and burning up the chaff with unquenchable fire.
I actually wrote the right book too.
4:17.
Uh-huh. 4:17.
From that time on, Jesus began to preach, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near."
So So that's a term you've got to repent before.
Time.
Especially when God takes you, when he takes you to the Holy Land, has said God in heaven. All your repentance has to be done before then. You've got to be repented before you get baptism. And baptism, after baptism, it's the Holy Ghost. So the first step is repent.
Right, I'm going to ask you if you would like to. This is a wee page, right? And this is about repenting. And next Tuesday at 2 o'clock, we'll have another class, right? And we're going to read up more about that repent. Okay. If you want to read it, and then when we come back, and it'll help you defend the pages back as well. You want a wee cup of tea?
Aye.
You want a wee biscuit?
Aye.
Okay. Right, now I'll give you a wee cup of tea.
Aye, cheers.
Oh! You see, I don't care before we finish.
Oh, okay.
We're thanking Jesus.
Yeah.
For you finding God and me finding God, and we're going to be happy. So thank you, Jesus, for this day. And thank you, Heavenly Father, for Jim, that he's going to be walking beside you always, Heavenly Father. And he will know what your pain is, and when he is very sorry, he will feel the grace of your love. Thank you, Jesus, amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Right. Okay, let's critique her a little here, in a good way. I think, Elizabeth, that you really have the ability to teach a Bible study, and I'm not just saying that. She was extremely caring. She was extremely understanding that he didn't know much, but not condescending. Okay? She was just helpful to you. She was so heartfelt. You know, you could just feel her care and concern for you. She didn't come across as a know-it-all. She came across as one who had really experienced the grace of God's forgiveness. And I thought you did very, very well. You were good at going back to the help him in the table of contents to find the page. I just thought you did really well. And I was impressed. I thought I could take a Bible study from her. Anybody else have something to say, pro or con? Okay, you prayed at the end. Always pray at the beginning. That's one thing to remember as well. And you asked him about a cup of tea. I'm surprised he didn't take the biscuit.
I know, so was that.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it's Nikki.
Mary Ann, you have any comment?
I was just in awe of him. I'm like, because I didn't know what to do in role play.
You don't have to. You don't have to. Mm-hmm. She chose to. And then Jeb's a good scapegoat here.
And then when she did that, I was like,
She just seemed so natural to me.
That's the word I was going to use now. Yeah. You just seemed natural. And I wouldn't have said that before I saw you do that. Yeah, so that's the value of doing this. But you seem
natural.
It seems so natural. And that's what kind of surprised and impressed me,
and
I didn't expect you to be like that, just so natural.
So, yeah.
So
it seemed to as if you were observing an actual Bible study. It wasn't
And I think the idea of using Jim is a good thing. I mean, you guys don't have to if you want to.
Because I kept on saying them against it.
No. I thought you were very good.
What's that?
Now, Jim, if you wanted someone, you could play the devil's advocate.
But
you were a very good student.
You
admitted you didn't know a lot. Okay, so that's good. All right, would you like to be baptized, Jim?
Hi, I'm Sharon. Pleased to meet you. What's your name?
Hi, Jim.
Jim, hi, Jim. How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
Yeah?
Well,
oh, wait a minute. I get to have a
look. This time I forgot my levels.
So how are we doing today? How's your day been?
Oh, my day's been good. It's been alright. Tired.
Tired, yeah.
Yeah.
And did you enjoy the service on Sunday?
Oh, yes. I did.
Okay, well, listen, I'm going to be teaching you about baptism today.
All right.
So, do you know much about baptism?
No. To be honest, not really. I was baptized as a baby.
Right, okay. I was baptized too as a baby, but later on, I realized that I needed to be baptized in Jesus' name.
Oh.
Yeah, someone pointed out the scriptures and things to me that I needed to be baptized in Jesus' name. And it's not just because the decision of baptism isn't for babies. Babies can't make the choice of being baptized.
Oh, okay.
You can do it as an adult or even children if you understand what baptism's all about. Then you're able to make that decision for yourself. Baptism is a personal thing. Mm-hmm. It's a personal choice. And when we baptize babies, we're actually making that decision for them rather than that child making the decision for themselves. So technically your parents were kind of doing that for you rather than you deciding yourself.
Okay.
Now, the reason why we get baptized, if we look up in Mark 16:16, it says, "He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be what?
Damned.
Shall be damned." Yeah. That's pretty heavy, isn't it?
Yeah.
And the purpose of our baptism in Acts 22:16, if you want to look that up.
Oh, I forgot my Bible.
That's all right, I've got it here, I'll set up for you.
Oh.
Okay, we're on Acts and we're looking up chapter 2.
Chapter 2?
Yep, and we're on verse 16.
Okay, verse 16, yeah, fine.
Yeah.
Would you like me to
read it? Yeah, read it out, that would be great.
"But this is that which was spoken by the prophet John. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams." And on my...
I'm sorry. I've actually got the wrong scripture. I'm sorry. It's 22.
22.
I'm sorry. Oh, my apologies. I'm so, so sorry.
22:16. There we go. Okay. "And now, why tarriest thou? Arise and be baptized and wash away thy sins, calling on the name of the Lord."
Yeah. So baptism, the purpose of baptism is to wash away your sins. Now, Sister Elizabeth was here earlier and she was speaking about repentance. Mm-hmm. And about how that you need to be able to ask God's forgiveness of your sins, of things that you've done in your past, and things that you've done wrong, and things that you've said that's wrong, and things that you're asking God to forgive you. You're saying sorry, and you're asking God to forgive you. And a way of to be forgiven is to be washed and cleansed by being down into the waters of baptism. And we don't do the sprinkling.
No.
Like we did as a baby, we got sprinkled as a baby, I remember that. But the Bible says that we need to be buried with him.
Right.
Now, what's the act of burial? Do you...
6 feet.
6 feet, where?
In the ground,
right, okay.
Yeah.
So you're under the ground. So therefore we should be under the water. Is it just our head that's buried?
No.
No? Is it just our body?
No.
It's our whole body, isn't it? So therefore our whole body should be immersed in water.
Right.
To be washed and cleansed and be baptized in Jesus' name. Okay. Now, although it says, Jesus said in Matthew 28:19, it says, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost,
yeah.
which is probably how you were baptized as a baby.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I know Jesus said this, uh-huh. but Jesus hadn't quite revealed himself as the Holy Ghost because he hadn't died. He hadn't died and he hadn't resurrected. So his spirit, you know, when you die and your spirit leaves your body,
mm-hmm.
you know. So his spirit wasn't there yet, so the Holy Spirit wasn't upon people yet until we had died and resurrected.
Okay.
Okay? So his spirit can't come and live within you until such time as the death and the resurrection happens.
Okay.
All right? So therefore, any time after that, if there's ever been a baptism, for example, when Philip came across the Ethiopian eunuch, he says he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they went down both into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him. And when they were come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more, and he went on his way rejoicing. And he commanded them to be baptized, what?
In the name?
Of?
The Lord.
Okay, now what is the name of the Lord? Do you know who the name of the Lord is?
Would the name of the Lord be Jesus?
Correct, yes, that's right.
Okay.
Now, you are, I take it you've got family?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, okay. Do you have children?
Not yet.
Not yet, okay. Have you got siblings?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so you're a brother?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're a brother. Has your siblings got children of their own?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're a brother, you're an uncle.
Mm-hmm.
But what's your name?
Jim.
Yeah. Okay, so Jesus, he's a father and he's a son and he's the Holy Ghost, but what's his name?
Jesus.
Jesus. So we baptize in the name of the Lord,
Jesus.
Which is
Jesus.
Jesus. Yeah. Is there any questions you would like to ask?
Do I have to be baptized?
It's important that we get baptized because we need to be baptized because to enter the kingdom of heaven. Yes. Nicodemus, there was a man called Nicodemus who came to Jesus and asked, what must I do to be saved?
Mm-hmm.
And he told him he needs to be born of water, which is baptism,
mm-hmm.
and of the Spirit, which is receiving the Holy Ghost,
mm-hmm.
in order to enter the kingdom of heaven. So if you want to enter the kingdom of heaven, you need to be baptized. And you need to have the Holy Ghost.
And I only have to be baptized only once?
Yeah, only once.
But what if I sin again?
You would be you would continually just your repentance after that.
Okay.
Yeah. What do you think of the baptism then? Would you like to get baptized? Is that a thing you would think about?
Yeah. Is it okay if I can just think about it?
Yes, uh-huh, sure.
Yeah.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay, would we like to pray just now?
Sure.
Yeah. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for this time together. And we ask in Jesus' name, Lord, that you bless us, Father, with this time and being able to understand your baptism, Father, and the way of entering into your kingdom, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you would just be with Jim right now, Lord, and help him to make the right decisions in his heart, Father, I pray, in Jesus' name. Bless us both, Lord, I pray, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay, would you like a wee cup of tea or a biscuit or...
Yes.
Yes.
Two pizza.
Yes, of course, I can put that one for you, no problem. Okay. Okay, did you enjoy that?
Yes. Thank you.
Okay, well, listen, we'll try and make a wee appointment maybe to see you next week as well. How would that sound?
That would be great.
Yeah?
That would be great, yeah.
Okay, it was lovely meeting you. Okay, God bless you.
All right, another well done. Karen said yesterday she'd never done this, but I think she did very well. This is one, fortunately you were dealing with someone who didn't know a lot in this role play. You could get into some tangles with Trinitarians here. She used the good example of you're a son, or you're a sibling, you're an uncle, you can go on, give everybody's titles, but that's not his name. Okay, so that was good. Another one that I have found very good that I've used many times with people who believe in the Trinity, and of course get baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, is an egg. An egg has a shell, it has a white, and it has a yolk, but it's not three eggs. That's three parts of an egg. It's one egg. Okay, and that is a good illustration as well to use. Or water. Water comes in various forms. It can be steam, it can be ice, it can be liquid, but it's still just water.
That would choose the egg.
I choose the egg too. That's the one I use the most. So it just depends on their level of knowledge. Someone like Jim, who in this role is not knowing a lot, is much easier to teach than a Trinitarian because they try to throw all this stuff at you. You can stand firm on the Word of God. No one after the day of Pentecost, no one in the Bible is recorded to have been baptized in the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost titles. It was always in the name of Jesus. The disciples weren't confused. They knew it was the name of Jesus. Now, one thing I have found, and I've used this people coming to the church, many people will say, and especially a lot of Africans, Jim, they'll all say, yes, I've been baptized in Jesus' name, but they really haven't. They don't realize the difference. And so a few years ago, the Lord gave me a way to ask them that was non-threatening but revealing. And not just Africans, but anybody. But I'd say, what did they say over you when you got baptized? I'll say, did they say Father, Son, and Holy Ghost? Yeah, that's what they said. And they walked right into my little boy there. Okay? So, a lot of people don't realize that there is a difference. But there is power in having the name of Jesus said over you. Now, the young people anymore don't write checks, but I've always used the illustration too. If I go to write a check, I can't put wife on the signature. I can't put daughter. I can't put sister. I have to put my name to empower that check, okay? So that's another good way to say you need the name of Jesus over your life. So that's very important, but this is good because all the scriptures are right there for them. They don't have to look up a lot on that chart. Right. Anybody else want to say anything to Sharon about her?
That was great.
I thought she did well. Very good. Okay.
And I like the way you've done it as well. Is when I say to them as well, your next step after repent is baptism, and then your community, the next step after is. So it's just for three.
Do you want me to take it much higher?
Huh?
Make it more difficult? Come in as a raging atheist.
Yeah, make it.
No, because I'm being very nice and very good. Come into the church.
Either way. They're extremely skeptical.
They and I usually wait and let them ask. I remember one of our first Bible studies was with Sister June's family. And oh my goodness, when we taught about baptism, they got so worked up. They actually had a recording of when they were baptized in the Baptist church, and they went and listened to it all, and that's when they realized no, they hadn't been baptized in the name of Jesus. So a lot of people think they have, but you got to be sure that it has the name of Jesus said over them. Okay, Mrs. Conway.
I'm scared now because I wasn't prepared to act this.
You don't have to act it. You don't have to act it. Jim, just fade away. Go have your pizza and tea.
I am. I'm still waiting for it.
You do it however you want.
Back.
You, there's no set right or wrong to this.
Do you want to jump back?
Because there's a good wee prompt to take,
Sherry. Go, Jim.
Jim, get back.
Get back.
Get back.
Sorry, Jim.
Is it just the one? Is it just the one?
It's up to you. You can do either or both.
Because the interesting thing is that it's just the one. And
yeah,
it's
just
one. One's just one. So I think
I'm not acting like they were up here.
You don't think I've done pretty good. I never used to
try. I was the actor.
I have just went blind. Okay. You spoke to Elizabeth and you spoke to Sham. Are you ready for the next step?
Alright.
The next step is have you received the Holy Ghost? You want to give me any thoughts first?
Like a ghost?
Do you know anything? Is there anything?
I know Casper.
See, he's thought I was bad yesterday.
I think that's the only my knowledge of ghosts. Like, I've never really heard of a holy ghost.
Just carry on.
Okay, Elizabeth spoke about repentance and then Sharon spoke about baptism. Okay. After that, did you have nothing about receiving the Holy Ghost?
Not really.
Okay. My mind's just went blank.
That's right, just relax.
It's part of after you're baptized. In the Bible, Jesus promised that after baptism, you'll be born saved and filled with the Holy Ghost. Okay? Jesus spoke of it and it was foretold. Do you want to read the first scripture?
Sure. Which?
Have you got
it? Yeah, I wrote it.
Okay, if you go to John 3 and 5.
Okay. John 3 and
5. Did Elizabeth show you?
Yeah, the curtain. I've gotten really good at it now. Hang on, I'm just so funny for the morning. John 3, 11?
3 and 5.
3 and 5. Jesus answered, I tell you the truth, unless a man...
No, what is it?
Unless a man is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God.
Okay, so let's go...
I remember that.
Okay, so this establishes the need. So he's said you need, and it's not kind of option thing. It's not if you get baptized, you might. You might receive. It's for everybody.
Yeah.
It's for everybody. Okay. It is essential.
Okay.
And that was emphasized. Do you know anything about you? I know you've been in these scriptures. Do you know Romans? Oh. You want to read that, and we'll get
Romans.
You want to